Hello and welcome to the Plastotech, the world of plastic. So guys, today I'm going to tell you about flash. In this particular video, I will tell you what is flash and what are the causes for the flash and how you can troubleshoot the flash from your pet preform so that your product should be in a good quality product you can manufacture by reducing the particular flash from your pet preform. So let's start. What is flash? Actually, flash is nothing. Flash is as simple. Flash is an extra material that has been over your product. For example, these are the two images. You can clearly see in this particular images what is there at your product, that is preform. In this particular preform, you can see some extra material is been there. So that extra material is called flash. So what are the two? I will tell you two major points that mostly cause the problem in your preform. So what is the first cause? The first cause is plastic force through parting line and vent due to an excess amount of material injected. That means your plastic, that means your molten plastic is forced through parting line and vent due to an excess amount of material injected. For example, this is your mold. These are the two sections of mold. This is your core section and that is your cavity section. Now when core and cavity meets, a minute line is being made here, that is called parting line or partition, and some vents are there in your mold to remove the trapped air from your mold. So these are the vents. So what happened when the molten plastic is forced inside the mold due to excessive injection pressure? So what happened when we will inject the molten material in the mold with a higher pressure? What happened? The material is exerted out. It comes out through parting line and vents, and it causes flash. An extra material is being sticken to your product, so that is called flash. So it's one of the most important cause, one of the most major cause that can damage your product. So I'm going to tell you how you can troubleshoot this. First of all, decrease shot size. By decreasing the shot size, that means that by decreasing the dosing stroke, you can just clear off the flash from your product. Now increase injection transition position. That means you have to increase the switch over position. When you will increase the switch over position, automatically the material will not come from the parting line and vents. Along with that, you should also have to decrease the holding pressure. By decreasing the holding pressure, your material will not just hold on to this mold. So it will not take some more time in holding with a higher pressure or with the higher time, so that your material should not come out from parting line and vent. So when you will reduce the holding pressure, your problem of flash will be reduced. And along with that, decrease injection pressure. By decreasing the injection pressure, you can decrease the amount of flash. I will repeat all the four points. First of all, you have to decrease the shot size. You have to increase the switchover position or transition position. You have to decrease the holding pressure and you have to decrease the injection pressure. Remember that everything, all the major settings, you have to decrease those settings so that you can just reduce your flash. Now I'm going to tell you second major point that caused the flash is plastic flows through parting line and vent due to low viscosity. Same reason in the first one, the extra material is coming from vent and parting line due to excessive amount of material or injection pressure. Now the plastic material will come from vent and parting line due to low viscosity. What happened in the low viscosity? At the low viscosity, your melt flow is higher. So I'm going to tell you some remedies so that you can solve these things. First point is reduce mold manifold temperature. In the mold, we put certain manifolds like HRTC and all. You can just simply reduce the mold manifold temperature so that the melt viscosity should be in proper condition. Reduce machine heats, or in simple language, we have to reduce the barrel temperatures. The barrel temperature should not be much higher, should not be much exceeded, so that your filling of the material in the mold should be proper. Now reduce system heat up time during startup. That means at the starting phase of the barrel, that is feed zone, you should not increase the temperature higher. The temperature should be at proper level or should be a little decreased. Decrease injection speed to allow melt front to cool during filling. You have to, in simple language, you have to reduce the injection speed. By reducing the injection speed, what will be there? When your melt friends, that is your melt friends, when these melt friends move inside the mold and just start filling the mold cavity, what happen? At, for example, this is filling the mold cavity. So at the starting point, it should be cooled. If you will reduce the injection speed, so what happen? At that, the starting flow, the starting point of the flow will be cooled down, and your chances of coming out extra material from the parting line and vent will be decreased. So these are the points. If you will do all these points, you can troubleshoot easily the problem of flash in your PET preform. So guys, subscribe our channel, press the bell icon, and stay connected with the Plastotech English. Thank you and have a nice day.